And this question is how to create a mid-side EQ in Patcher. So this is a really good question. And I'm going to actually use the same project here. So let me switch to FL Studio. And let's do that. And so we have to hear the project, the beat actually. Okay, so now let's do a FL Studio, a mid-side EQ in Patcher. So let's go here, Patcher. Let's load Patcher. And if I play now, nothing happens because there's no connection between Patcher and the input and the output of Patcher. You can also go here and we have a mid-side internal EQ sidechain, but maybe this mid-side would be enough. But I want to show you the entire process that I usually do to create these processors or these effects. So one thing that I like to do is bring a steady shaper. And if I go here, I go and I select, for instance, this mixing, and let's do mid A side splitter like that. And now if I listen to this, the track became mono. So how can I now bring the other side into the mixer? So what I can, or into the path, the audio path, what I can do is go here, output audio, and I'm not sure which one is it by memory. So let's go with send one. Let's mute the other one. It's not send one. Probably send two. Let's try send two. Yeah, it's send. Oops, let me take this out. Okay, so we have this one here, which is the side section. And we have this one, which is the mono. So both together, they sound as the beat normally. If I take this, the patcher off, you notice no difference. So now what I like to do, I like to add a plugin. So let's do the Fidelity EQ. And let's bring, for instance, for the side here, and let's add another Fidelity EQ. And you can use whatever plugin you want. And you just add this up, and now you have a mid-side EQ. So what I can do is mute the mono side and then start just changing here the parameters. Let's bring a little bit of the high frequencies, like that, for instance, just an example. And I can go here and start doing some EQ into the mono side. So I like the bass. Let's bring this a little bit higher. And what else? Let's take this out a little bit. Like that. So I want to make a little bit drastic changes so that you can really see the effect. So now if I go and enable and disable, you see that you can really craft carve. Sorry, I'm switching the terms. You can really change the way the sound, your track sounds by using this mid-side EQ. And it's one of the best tools It's one of the best tools that I like to use for mastering, because I can really, really change how it sounds or improve the sound in terms of mono and side compatibility. And I think this is a really cool tool to have. And if you like to do this, you can just go ahead and save this preset as, and you can have your own preset with your own configurations. And this can really speed up your process of making beats.